let's get this show started. Or as John Clark would say, let's make this movie. All right, what we have for you now is I'd say monstrous white pine. It's going to be a little ignorant to Saul, but we'll get through it. We always do. And we got the oil change in the old bus motor. All right. Let's find a face to open this up with. I slowed my hydraulics down a little bit more. It just makes it nicer to make precise sets. I'm trying to find a lower spot, because this is going to be, we're going to have to make a stop sign here for a little bit. And that's just the way these work. All right, let's put the old master dog down. How's that sound, Jerry? That piece of bark out of there real quick. And the bus motor sounds good. Thank everybody for their comments. Being helpful about a problem with the fuel slobbering, but we'll figure it out. I can take just a, I'm just trying to get a flat spot so I don't need a chainsaw. Then we'll roll it back. Might be able to open just a little bit. Not much, but a little bit. We'll be able to take another little. That'll be about it. We'll have to start kicking it back. Well, oh, sorry about the camera. Big log on a carriage. Every once in a while, I forget my thoughts. Alright, let's kick it back a little bit. Get down to our magic number. And everybody's seen Frickin' Jeep does this down to Jeff's Mill. Common practice. All right, I didn't forget to turn you this time. And we'll go ahead and set one full board. If everybody watches this video all the way through, it's going to be, I'm going to try to do both logs on it. It's going to be a long sawing video. We have a little treat at the end. All right, I think I'm going to kick it a little bit more. I'm so close to my 2022, but I know if I get greedy now, I'll regret it. All right, Master Dog, do your job.
put the... Someone asked me about the master dog. If the master dog has a name, what do you call the other dogs? Well, I said, we call them worker dogs. I thought it was kind of funny. Never thought of it. But they're actually referred to as a tong dog. T-O-N-G, like a set of tongs. That'll recover at least usable wood off of this. This log isn't rotted at all. That's about as close as you can get right there. Oh, that's not usable. Went tapered. That's the problem. When you're pushing these big logs out, you might not be in contact with all three. I'm at 23. I'm going to lay it down on that flat spot now, and we're going to take our chances with it. We're going to go with it. How's that sound? Try to put the dogs in. Sometimes these are a little ornery to turn. You want to go back there and get the bark? Yeah, Eddie's going to go back there, so bear with us, people. It'll all be all right in the end. And Eddie is in no way in danger. Any small animals. Looks good. Eddie gave me the green light, so there we go. That the old cat kickers do their job, or the loader arms do their job. And let's get a nice little flat area on here. We don't need the master dog no more. Let's start making some lumber. How's that sound? And the reason I'm not taking these big hog cuts off, because when it gets up to Buzzy at the swing saw, it'll be nothing but troubles for him to fight. Big, thick pieces. So, I got a piece of bark underneath. I gotta go out there one more time. Underneath there's a piece of bark dragging. I put a set. No, I didn't. Yeah, I see that, Ed. It pulled the old taper trick to us, but this is a better board to edge off, so. There you go. And I think I'm going to try to get greedy here and go for one more. We got to do something with that end anyway, so I'll deal with it one time, not four times. That's a pretty little piece of pine there. that big old nubby, I might have to get, I'm gonna send it down to Eddie, see if he can smash that. I think there's an axe laying out there somewhere. I'll pull it down a little bit more for him to. Sorry about the camera. I was getting ready to turn it. I'm gonna let Eddie take care of the little problem. How would you like the Eddie Horvath coming at you with that axe, huh? That's right in that knot, and that couldn't be in a worst. And that's where, you know, the top saw would be nice just for little stuff like that. All right. Good job, Eddie. And little stuff like that, you deal with it. No big deal. We live through it. Kind of liking these hydraulics slowed down a little bit. Now I'm trying to do is get that face down. I think we got a bunch of bark underneath there. Yep. Gonna get something and shove that out of there now. Always fight bark. I might just take that thing for a spin around. See that? We survived it. Alright, we're tight. And we'll dog her down and let's continue this bad boy. Again, I'm going to take it down in chunks. Here. use the mark to get out of the way. The last log's a nice little log. I'm gonna shove his back a little bit. There we go. Whittle this face down. Now we're going to turn it back up and I'm going to go for a 12 inch parallel. New cable wheels, the shib wheels for the cable. I was watching John had some problems with his cable on his mill, so I just took a good look at everything and had a nice conversation with Johnny Edmiston, and they shipped them wheels out. They were here 2 days later, man. We needed them bad. Take that top face off a little bit. I can see it is not square at all there. Down to 12 inches. That looks even better. Sometimes your best decisions are made on the fly. All right, let's clean that face up and start taking the boards off and get it down to 12 inches. So we need, I'm trying to read my list here. That's one of them barky pieces that were causing us all the grief. Alright, wedge something nice out of that. Okay, I see something happen here. Let me turn this back. I got a little bit out of square going on here. Bark was interfering with us. See what's going on there? That's like a big shingle. Alright. Let me see what that looks like. Turn that face back out and see how it sits. All Yeah, that bark can really... mess things up for you. See, but that looks good. Took care of the problem. Now let's get on to our 12 inches. We'll get one more piece. Pretty piece of wood all day long. Minus the bark prop. All right, let's lay it down and start pulling off a bunch of 1x12. See how it cleans up. Tell you what, that laser's really, really close. Yes. That's just gonna be some pretty 1x12 all day long. That log was sitting, 6 months anyway. Something here. All right. That end's ready to bust off. Alright, see what happens when you get to the center of the log. Here's where all your trouble goes. In fact, I need some 1x8, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to carve this down. That'll get us right to the other side of that hardwood. Then we'll go down to my 8-inch. Okay, we're gonna lay it down and pull some 1x8 off of this order. have a little bit of a bow in it. Good. And 1x8. Three 1x8s. Saw and look at this list and talk to you at the same time. Sorry if I'm ignoring you. Try to get a hold of Eddie, so he's looking at me. Four, we're gonna cut in half. Alright. Four of them we're gonna cut in half, that's what I'm trying to tell Eddie, and I think he grasped what we were gonna do here. They want some 1x4. See, there's that split end again. That is down inside the guide. Hopefully it don't. Okay, there's your 2-inch piece at the end. We're gonna leave that. Back on. And the 1x4 is going to end up to be just a 1/8 inch shy. I hope it clears that piece that's laying in there. Alright, let's take it down. Gonna go just slightly. There he goes. That's like 3 7/8. I don't know what's gonna happen with that little piece there. Yeah, let's get that out of there. A sticky wood probably ruined the video. All right, this is what happens. No other bark down in there. I think it looks good. All right, let's get the next log on there. In fact, we're going to let you go here.
And
we'll be with you here in a minute.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what. That was a lot of individual pieces, and most mills won't take these orders.
But we strive on the custom.
Yeah, we are a boutique sawmill. We do, if they want it, we cut it, you know. But it's good to know what you're cutting. As far as the bus motor goes, the fresh oil change work, we're going to go ahead and get the fuel pump, put a rebuild on here. And a lot of people keep pointing towards that. I had started it up with the valve cover off, and there was no fuel leaking from any of them lines. There's 12 lines underneath there. Two lines go to injectors. And if they leak, they can do the same thing as that would do. So, and someone had sent us bus motor paint. So once we get this slobbering done, we can go ahead and give it a good pressure wash and give it a fresh coat of paint. And here it is. There's a lot of pieces there. And like I said, most people, I don't think they'd even want to touch an order like this. It's just a real, there was some pine, a little bit of hemlock. That one hemlock, we thought it was actually pine from the bark. And here's some extra boards here we're going to throw, just stack these into the kiln chamber, because we're not working on the kiln right now, but it's so darn hot in there. I think we could kiln wood in there, small amounts. We're going to throw them in there. And also the watermelon slice.
It was very good.
It was. Okay, so thank everybody, the 42,175 subscribers as of now.
Anybody that isn't.
And please share the video with your friends and tell them to subscribe. And Nathan, you're going to have to saw a watermelon. or frickin' Jeep.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe between John and then someone else said that John and us should have a ugly log contest.
Oh, yeah, it wouldn't.
Who could saw the ugliest log? And I think John, he might have us beat.
He might win. I don't like
him. He might win, yeah. I don't like ugly logs. It's just, it causes us a bunch of grief, so... thank everybody for watching, and if you did not like this video, please send it to someone you don't like and aggravate them. So have a great week. We'll see you Friday Eve.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.